Hey, the Lord bless you, Evangelist Robb here of Robb Woods Ministries. Just some clarity, some language, some light being brought to some of the voices and even what the Lord show me of what's coming on the earth. And, you know, friends, you might think it could be dueling prophets. Who's right? One camp is saying the best of times, revival, awakening, outpouring, the harvest of souls like we've never seen. The glory of God, the anointing hitting the church of Jesus. Another camp saying there's judgment coming, the wrath of God, severities, trials, the beginnings of birth pangs, sorrows, the contractions intensifying like Jesus spoke about in Matthew 24. Now, I'm going to pray the prayer of faith for strength in about 3 minutes. Before I continue the show, it'd be an honor if you'd subscribe to the channel, hit the like button. Specific prayer requests you can put in the comment section. They could be health, relational, or financial. I am live every Monday night, 9 p.m. Eastern, YouTube. Go to my channel, Robb Wood 1, YouTube live, Mondays Eastern, preaching, prophesying, and praying. These are not 6-minute prophetic rants. These are blast hour of power. Now, again, which voice is right? Friends, just bringing some clarity, both, because simultaneously Jesus did talk about the great and terrible day of the Lord, the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And I believe for some it's going to be a great awakening. For others, it's going to be a rude awakening. In other words, the separation's not begun. It's here. The grayness is over. The Lord has separated the wheat from the tares. Angels, demons, light, darkness, heaven, and hell. You know, before the harvest gets ready to be harvested, the head of the grain bows down in the natural and becomes heavy. Jesus said, let the wheat and the tares grow up together. This way you'll know the difference. So the Lord's brought a sword upon the land. The sword divides. Like in Ezekiel 33, the ministry and mantle and candle of the watchman. The watchman would go on a wall, on a rampart, on a roof, blow the trumpet or the ram's horn or the shofar to warn for impending danger. Now, they can also blow the shofar for the coming of the Lord, the presence of the Lord coming in a great, mighty way, a season of the greatness of God. So, friends, I do believe both voices are correct. The Lord has spoken to me personally. You know, you come with an audible voice. Robb, come here. I want to tell you. Come on. You get impressions. You sense scripture. You sense the Holy Spirit speaking. I don't really get dreams or visions in the natural. You know what I'm saying? I get the Lord speaks to me, the Holy Spirit. I could walk in a diner. It's happened. The Lord gives me not people's names, but their nicknames, their children's nicknames. This has happened. My friends are like, what the heck? Says, though, your son's name's Little Mikey. You don't call him Michael or Mike or Mike. You call him Little Mike. The woman's like, you. So anyway, that's how the Lord speaks to me. He speaks to different people in various ways. Different people carry different gifts. But the Lord has spoken to me about tribulation coming to the earth. He spoke to me 4 months ago. And he said what's in the book, The Vision by David Wilkerson, written in 1973, is going to come to pass and manifest in full fruition on the earth a lot. And that was like right after the COVID and then the protests with George Floyd. Certainly my condolences as a minister to a horrible tragedy. But friends, Jesus said in Matthew 24, nation against nation. In the Greek, that means ethnic groups against ethnic groups. Are we to tell people to prepare for difficult days? Look, there are some storms and battles that could be diverted and stopped. Some cannot be stopped in totality. There are some storms that the Lord, in his sovereignty and the filter of his sovereignty, he has to allow it to ride out. You know, it's a mystery. Maybe it could be for purging, cleansing, some pride, backsliddenness, coldness of heart in the church. The wake up, the Lord can and does allow persecutions, not all the devil, demons. The Lord allows, he doesn't initiate it, but he allows it. The word plague and pestilence mentioned over 100 times in the battle. So, friends, there is a coming battle and storm raging. I believe it's because there's a massive harvest of souls the church has never seen. I'm talking a billion souls in the next 20 years, more souls in the next 20 years, born again, coming into the kingdom of God than in the last 2,000 years. And the point I'm trying to make, you think the devil's going to sit back and allow this and not put up a fight? Now, there's not no power like the Lord. Come on now. This is not a fair fight. God has all the power, Jesus. Bible says God sneezes, one nostril, bam, the Antichrist is gone. You know, he just proves a point. He covers one nostril, he sneezes, he's gone. Blows his nose. He said the real power and sovereignty belongs to the Lord, but God has a plan where he does want his church to rise up. And if everything's handed to them on the silver platter and they need eye salve, they have need of nothing. There's no urgency. We're not compelled. You understand what I'm saying? We have no need of thee. Father, strengthen my friends on YouTube. Let them endure to the end. Give them grace for the race. But friends, brace yourself. There is a battle coming and a storm raging. Hey, praise the Lord. If you made it this far, subscribe. It'd be an honor. Again, 9 p.m. YouTube live Monday nights. Preaching, prophesying, praying. The Lord bless you. Amen.